In this session, we are going to discuss about the experimental procedure of the fin tip heat exchanger. Now, first of all, we must know what exactly the fin is. The fin is nothing but the metallic pieces which can be mounted on the tube side, that may be along the length or that may be perpendicular to the length of the tubes. If the metallic pieces, that is fins, is mounted along the length of the tubes, then it is called as longitudinal fins, and if it is mounted or welded in the perpendicular direction of the tubes, then it is called as transverse fins. So this is the transverse fins, fin tube heat exchangers, where these tubes you can observe on the side of this fin tube heat exchanger, on this side also. So these tubes are connected, and this is the fin arrangement in a perpendicular to the tubes, right? So these are the transverse fins. So this is the fin tube heat exchanger, that is nothing but the radiator of a four wheeler, and this radiator is one of the heat exchanger, and this type is fin tube heat exchanger, right? So the main objective of the fin tube heat exchanger experiment is to calculate the heat transfer coefficient. So for the calculation of this heat transfer coefficient, we must require the different parameters like volumetric flow rate of hot water, then temperature inlet and outlet of hot water as well as of air, and then the air velocity of this air. So for satisfying these needs of the calculation, we will observe the different parts of this experimental setup. So I will show you the various parts involved in this experimental setup. This is one of the important part, that is temperature indicator or digital temperature display with on-off knob. So we have to measure the temperature inlet and outlet of air so we can observe this reading. So this is the first RTD, which shows you 41 degrees Celsius, and it is a second RTD which shows you 34 degrees Celsius. So this is, first one is air outlet and second one is air inlet. Then third one is 48 degrees Celsius and fourth one is 38 degrees Celsius. So this third reading is related to the hot water inlet, and fourth reading is hot water outlet. So these are the four temperatures of air inlet outlet and hot water inlet outlet, right? Then another part is the set point apparatus, where you can set the temperature whatever we required. Now for this case, we set 65 degrees Celsius is the maximum temperature, and now we are getting 51.4 degrees Celsius as a current condition temperature, right? Then this is the rotameter, from where we can check the volumetric flow rate of the hot water. So it is near about 120. Then this is the fan, where from we can provide the air, and this direction of air is perpendicular to the tubes. So this air is going to pass through these transverse fins, and here RTD is attached for measuring the outlet temperature of air. Then this is the water inlet. So this
pipe arrangement, water tank arrangement, heater arrangement and pump arrangement is involved. So by switch on the pump, by switch on the heater and by opening this valve, we can transfer this hot water through this pipe to this fin tube heat exchanger, that is from the bottom. And at this bottom, here again one RTD is there. So this RTD gives you the idea, that is temperature of the hot water inlet. Then this water is flowing from one point to another point, that is at the end of the fin tube, and again it is going to flow through all these tubes, and here it is a outlet of this hot water. So for measuring the temperature of hot water outlet, again here RTD is arranged, right? So in this way we can put on the switch off heater, then put on the switch on pump, and we can start the experiment. Now if we get the readings of temperature inlet outlet of the hot water and air, then we have also observed the reading of volumetric flow rate. Now if we get the reading of air velocity with the help of anemometer, then we can calculate the heat transfer coefficient. Now we will check the air velocity with the help of anemometer. So this is the anemometer setup, where one point, that sensor is having the fan arrangement which is connected to this digital display assembly, and if we put this fan at the exit of this fan assembly, that is exit at the fin tube heat exchanger, then we get the reading directly on this anemometer digital display. So this reading may be in terms of meter per second, that may be in terms of dots, etc. Right? So with the help of these all readings, we can calculate the heat transfer coefficient of fin tube heat exchanger. Thank you.